apparently it's impossible to draw a heptagram with a straight edge and a compass because you can't divide a circle into seven. Well, if that's true, then I shouldn't be able to draw this. I'm going to give it a go. I've never actually drawn a heptagram before, but that's what I'm going to try and draw today. So I'll start off with two circles, one above the other, and I'll make this vesica Pisces. Then I'll join the center of each circle with a line. Then I can join the points where the two circles cross, and that'll give me the center of the vesica Pisces. And then if I set my compass to this length here, then that'll tell me approximately how to divide the circle into seven. So I can draw seven of these circles around the outside of the middle circle. And by the time I get to the end, they should all match up. I've heard a few people say that this symbol is evil. A lot of people say sacred geometry is evil. I don't know how you can say this symbol is evil. Look, this pattern's been around way before humans declared what was good and what was evil. And I don't think you can really classify a symbol as good or evil because it's all about the intention of the person using it, isn't it? Are they using it for good or are they using it for evil? That's up to them. Check this out, right? The last two circles don't quite meet. So it is true. It is impossible to divide a circle into seven. It's almost there. So what I'm going to do here is just find the little space in between the two circles and put my compass point right there and draw the last circle there. And then it's close enough. We can work with it. Now I can join these, like, see how it's got like these petals that kind of come out of the middle circle. If I join the tips of those petals to each other. So what I'll do is I'll go from one and then I'll skip one and join it to the next one. And if we do that all the way around, that'll give us a heptagram. It's not going to line up perfectly, I don't think. So if you wanted to make a perfect heptagram, you gotta, I don't know, either do it on a computer or use a protractor. But this is the beauty of drawing by hand, you know? It's still possible. And like, to the naked eye, you're not really gonna tell that it's not perfect. So that's the heptagram there. And it looks pretty good, I think. Now I'm gonna make it like a knotted heptagram by joining the tips of the seven petals that are inside the main circle. The points where the main circle has been divided, if you know what I mean. Of all the numbers between 1 to 10, 7 is the only number which cannot be divided into a circle. So the ancients took this as a reminder of the presence of the indescribable spirit that's all around us. It's always doing its thing, but you can't see it, you can't touch it, you can't even fully sense it, but you know it's there and you know it's doing its thing. I don't know why, but I feel like drawing the lines freehand. Why not? Sometimes it's good to give the pens a break, because as much as I try not to rub the pen against the steel rule, I'm sure it's doing some damage. Like, I haven't actually seen any damage, but I'm sure it's doing some damage by scraping the nib across a piece of steel. Can't be good for the pen, can it? Trying to make my pens last here. So let's freehand these lines. Going back to whether this is good or evil, this symbol can be used to ward off evil intentions because seven was seen as a holy, pure number. There's something special about the number seven. Each moon phase lasts 7 days. That's why a week is 7 days. There are seven colors in the rainbow, the prism of white light, you know? The seven notes in the musical scale. You know, there's so many links to seven. So seven's a good number. Also, back in the day, people used this symbol to refer to the seven planets. Back then, before telescopes, they didn't know that there were more than seven planets. I mean, they could actually only see five planets, but they thought that the sun and the moon were also planets, you know? If you want to learn more about that, the meaning behind numbers, there's a book I just read called Elements of the Cosmos by Senza. Pretty interesting. I'll put a link to that in the description. So that's one way to draw the heptagram, but we can draw another one, which is like the elven septagram, by joining the points in a different way. So instead of skipping one like we did before, you'd skip two. I'll just draw this in behind the other one. So this will make the elven heptagram, which is actually called the elven star, which is a symbol used in pagan traditions, something to do with magic. I can't really remember. The reason why I like the heptagram so much is it's used by one of my favorite bands of all time, Tool. They use it for their, what do they call it now? Tool Army. I'm not a member of it, but I have bought all their CDs. But they leave it open at the bottom, and that symbolizes an invite to the collective consciousness. And you know what? We can also get a heptagon out of this. There's already two heptagons inside if you look close, but you can also use the points that we used at the start on the ends of those petals. You can use them to draw a heptagon as well around the outside. And if you want to make it really metal, put a few circles around the outside. There you go. If you enjoyed this, hit the like button, subscribe for more sacred geometry tips and tricks. Support the channel on Patreon if you want to be so kind. And yeah, thanks for watching. See you in the next one. It's all right.